guys, this is Hengist from House of Hengist Comics, and a big welcome back to the channel. Thanks for all your messages and your continued support. This is Blitzkrieg, and today it's episode 4, Maastricht. But first, the news, and let's have a quick look at what the international papers are saying. Holland, Belgium and Luxembourg have been invaded by land and air, and the dikes have been opened. Now, importantly, this is the battle map. The Germans are intending to sweep round with this sickle plan through Sedan. But if we look at our local tactical situation report, it's Maastricht and Eben-Emael, and please keep your eye on Batiste, which is coming up. Ultimately, the Dutch forces today, let's have a look at them. Well, they're green, so they're reluctant but confident trained with a reluctant command. These are rolled for. Let's have a quick look at their uniforms. It's a bluey green as such. But they've got four platoons, basically, with anti-aircraft, anti-tank guns and some support weapons, which they'll also be getting, including some mortars. We'll also see some bicycle troops and a platoon of Marines. Key characters within this are Colonel van Klaarbergen and Acting Corporal Edzard van Zanten. Let's now look at the German forces and what they've got. Well, today it's commandos. It's the original commandos, the Brandenburgers. They're basically being developed by the Abwehr through Canaris. They're highly trained for land, sea and air operations, for sabotage, infiltration, pick, because they can speak several languages and know the local customs. As we can see from this historical photograph, they are operating in Holland quite successfully and received a large number of Iron Crosses. They're led today by a Lieutenant, I think his name was Wilhelm Volter, he's only 22, and he's supported as well by Kurt von Kurland. He's coming with his Sparwagen, which include 4 rads, 6 rads and 8 rads. So it's basically an infantry assault at night, supported by armour, which will be arrived later in the night and early in the day, and they'll have Stukas to support them. Okay, let's now look at the setup and the mission in itself. Basically, this is supposed to be a replication or simulation of the city, the old city quarter of Maastricht. We've got Café Renard here, and to the south of that is the hotel. We've got Corporal van Zanten's billet, which is right on the bridge. The police headquarters, the large building with the flag on it. We've also got an access road where some of the Dutch reserves will be arriving, not all of them. We've also got the tram centre with its trams per se. These can be moved up and down by the Dutch, and obviously we've got the bridges themselves, and we tried to use historical photographs to try and get it pretty damn close. These are all mined. There are two bridges across the canal in itself, and we've also got sluice gates, which we had to hastily build out of balsa. Ultimately, the sluice gates are only open for infantry. Both the other bridges can take vehicles or armoured cars. The farm in itself, that's just slightly north of the sluice gates. And if we look back here, we'll also see how complex and dense the terrain is, and line of sights and ranges are important. Let's look at the rules. So it's play up and play the war game. Basically, we're using Achtung Panzer again. Effectively, the key to this is the battle deck, which provides all the historical and research information we've got in, and weather. And there are three core elements to this: skill, motivation and reaction. Right, let's now look at the deployment and the objectives for today. Well, basically, as we can see, it's 15 turns, with effectively the Germans have to take both bridges to win this outright. Historically, the bridges are blown, and they're going to use a three-turn infiltration prior to this. As you can see from the bridges, there's a lot of cover in terms of on the bridges themselves, but once they get over there, it's a real mishmash, and we've got street lighting into effect. So everywhere you see a street light, there's a 6-inch bubble of real light, so it's daylight under those street lights. They've got a bunker as well and some wire, as you can see down. So without further ado, let's get into the game. It's night, but the Dutch are on high alert. This is an expected avenue of attack. And what we see at 3:15 are two groups approaching the Dutch guards at the bridge. One group appear to be workmen, the other appear to be a patrol group with German prisoners. Now, as they arrive at the guard, a reaction is supposed to be rolled for and is failed. and effectively the Dutch guards allow the workmen through who are looking for a way to get under the bridge and remove the demolition charges, and hastily move towards Ed Zanton's billet. Now, what we've also got is basically the Dutch infantry are heading straight basically for the police headquarters. Immediate ambush goes down, which is bunkers and anti-tank guns. And as the Dutch, basically alleged Dutch, I should say, move towards the headquarters, effectively the workmen are milling around, but they've got SMGs under their long coats, and the impuniously the Germans basically go straight into the headquarters as the workmen continue to sort of hang around, attracting attention, unfortunately. And then what we see is the Brandenburgers start moving up, both on the rail bridge and now at the sluice gate, as you can see here. What the Germans then decide to do is make an immediate attack across that sluice gate. But because basically the Brandenburgers' reaction was made, they opened fire, there's a gun battle outside the house. And so the Brandenburgers on the sluice gate assault. We've also got the Brandenburger Pioneer Platoon now moving up towards the bridge, and we've got the other platoon which is moving straight onto the bunker and the anti-tank gun. There's all sorts of fire now starting to take place with tracer rounds onto that bridge, and the Germans start to take casualties. In fact, basically Walther's platoon are effectively butchered by Van Zanten's men and basically run for the underneath the bridge. Meanwhile, the Germans surprise the police, overrun it effectively, and what we see is only Van der Velde, the inspector, escaping. He was then to fail sole survivor and disappear. The Germans now begin assaulting vigorously against the Dutch, who've ambushed, and basically a gun battle takes place there. As we see Dutch reserves arrive, moving up the access road towards Café Renard. They are basically about nine bases strong in platoon strength. Now, as you can see, Walther is under the bridge trying to refine the demolition charges. The Pioneers are moving on and up towards the bridge, and Van Zanten's men are basically firing anything that moves, basically. Dutch infantry also now ambushed by the bridge, and there's an awful crossfire for the Germans now, with machine guns, the bunker and everything, and they're being pinned down and shot to pieces as the Dutch also bring in mortar fire, and also they use star shells as well for illumination. Well, German headquarters now that are sighted on the warehouse on the other bank start firing with their mortars as well to try and give some sort of covering fire and smoke to try and produce triple concealment, which would give no visibility to Walther's men. But civilians are now caught in the crossfire as the Germans open up from the police headquarters, and quite a few are going down. The Dutch are incensed at this. They won't fire back where civilians are present. But this is desperate stuff, and school children now run out onto the street. The Dutch don't fire, but the Germans fire and fortunately miss them. At the farm, the Brandenburg platoon, which was at the sluice, is driven in, repulsed and ineffectively destroyed in the farmhouse. And the Brandenburgers move on. They've taken a few casualties, but not really a lot. And we then get a card which produces the Dutch sort of fifth column. They then attack the headquarters where Klaarbergen is. And he also has Dutch nationalists basically there as well, and they basically produce a massive fight in which it's Dutchman against Dutchman, and it's really, really brutal stuff. But basically Klaarbergen manages to win with a pistol shot and basically puts them down, and now begins to panic. He basically places his ambush in the hotel as seen here, and he's now keen to get hold of those demolition charges and race back to that position. We've now got smoke being fired again as the German pioneers now try and get across that bridge. But we also now get dawn, and with dawn comes the Germans and their aircraft. It's basically Stukas again, who wail down Horns of Jericho rule in play and start basically bombing and trying to pin the mortar pits. It's very intense at this stage. There's all sorts of things going, and Curlin arrives with his armoured cars into a withering hail of fire. As Walther orders the pioneers to assault, he's pulled the wires out of that thing, out of the bridge, but hasn't removed the charges. We've got a battle on the rail bridge, and then Van Klaarbom depresses the plunger, but it fails to go off. Germans basically on these bridges are now running hell-mell to get off the bridges, so to speak. There's mortar fire. They make a flamethrower attack into Van Zanten's house. Van Zanten basically gets singed and burned, and we get gummi putchen, which have been dropped But again, the Dutch don't fail reaction and get drawn off by this. They're producing brilliant saves throughout this game and fight like real heroes. Van Zanten, especially with his SMG firing and basically holding off the pioneers, you can see the amount of damage that they're inflicting here. It's getting very, very desperate, basically, for the Germans on the bridge. Volther is basically in serious, serious trouble. He's got one heavy machine gun left, and that's about it. And the armoured cars are taking fire all over the place as well. He ultimately breaks and runs pell-mell, wounded, down the bridge. Also gets accidentally shot by his own troops. And then again, another depression of the plunger on the railway bridge. But for whatever reason, a one is rolled. It looks like mortar fires cut the bridge and basically doesn't detonate as Dutch troops arrive. Kernan looks really frightful on this bridge. He doesn't know what he can do. The mortars keep firing. The infantry are moving up and the Dutch continue to press. Now they've got hold of Renault's cafe. They're firing back. The streets are emptying. An anti-aircraft platoon is now basically deployed. And although the town has gone quiet, there's tracer fire and gunfire all across the streets. It's very, very tense at the moment. The bridge fire is basically, and the battle that's going on there continues, and artillery ranges in. Kurland's men now start putting hell into Van Zanten's house and shooting. We get a series of assaults by the Germans who take the anti-tank gun and then blow the bunker, attacking it from the rear where they get increased anti-tank value. Then the Marines arrive very close to the brothel but swerve past that. Some Marines take a good look. And basically, we then see basically the anti-aircraft fire now deployed in a sort of anti-tank role. A mad dash car is playing, and Dutchman basically runs into Van Danten's house, basically strapped down, and fires and basically takes out a forerad. We've got all sorts of stuff going now on the bridge. There's damage all over the place, and an anti-tank ambush occurs now, and that takes out another forerad basically on the railway bridge. It's mayhem. There's shooting going on all over the place in the streets. The anti-tank gun that the Brandenburgers have, just the one, starts firing at Van Zanten's house. I mean, what hasn't it been shot at with? And basically, we've got casualties really seriously mounting for the Germans. The bicyclists start to become trapped in their own wire, which is very frustrating for them. But the Marines move up to try and remove the garrison that is now basically in the police headquarters. Again, more small arms fire exchanged throughout. But the platoon that was in the farmhouse now moves in to attack that platoon on the bridge. Again, we've got basically Kurland ordering his men to fire, but you can see the amount of damage. These are tyres that have been shot out, and basically his vehicles are in real trouble on that bridge. Artillery has now finally ranged in. The Germans are becoming desperate and incensed, and ultimately Van Zanten, seriously wounded, burnt, out of ammunition, is pulled out by the rest of his men. They just can't take it anymore, and they pull back. We've also got an attack now against the police headquarters, and in that, ultimately, initially they're repulsed. Stukas basically come in against Café Renard. Six rads cross the bridge, and there's fire all over the place as the anti-tank guns are shooting. But the armoured cars start to get off that bridge and start peppering everywhere. I mean, there's bullets all across the new plaster and brickwork, much to the annoyance of the mayor. And we get also massive counterattacks by the Dutch, including the Marines, who finally take the police headquarters and charge out, and for three turns fail tank terror. They would have destroyed basically Kurland, who's sitting there with no tyres, basically running out of ammunition. But the Germans basically come to save the day, who've left the farm. They assault really vigorously, but their blood is up, possibly even berserk. They're shooting like mad. We've got double mobility problems for Kurland. As I said, all his tyres are out, his vehicles are all damaged on that bridge, and it is very, very tense. Ultimately, the Germans who attacked basically from that farmhouse, when the Dutch break, don't give any quarter and shoot the poor Dutchman down on the wire. Whew. Well, ultimately we ran out of time. It was the 12th turn, and although the armoured cars have got into the town, they're unsupported. It's very few bases of infantry left. So it was a minor German victory for 15 points. Crikey, what a game. This was just absolutely epic. And basically, we'll go down in club legend. As we all shook hands, none of us could have believed it. It was just an epic game. The Dutch under Klarberg and held. I mean, Curland did the very best he could. I mean, the German infantry were magnificent as well, although a bit dubious at times. But let's never forget the fallen. And in these war games, we should always sort of try and understand what was going on. So this is Blitzkrieg. It's over and out from me.